You'll hear this sound, and I'll ask you for another.
Right.
All right, can I remind the viewers at home of the answers that Mike gave us? And can I have 20 seconds on the clock, please? Name a sporting event seen on television once a year.
The Derby.
An animal sold in a pet shop.
A rabbit.
Another.
A dog.
An instrument played in a jazz band.
A clarinet.
An occasion when families get together.
Wedding.
A country in South America.
Chile.
Well done. Okay. 65 we need. First of all, I asked you to name a sporting event seen on television once a year. You said? The Derby. Our survey said? Five. Oh. Five people said the Derby. We need 60. Top answer was Wimbledon.
Was it really?
31 people said Wimbledon. An animal sold in a pet shop, I asked you. You said? Dog. Our survey said? 20. Yeah. We need 60. 40 to get. Then I asked you to name an instrument played in a jazz band. You said? Clarinet. It has to be worth 40 or more to win the money. Mm-hmm. You said clarinet. Our survey said? 4. 164.
It's getting a bit tight, Les.
Yeah. By the way, the top answer for the animal was a rabbit, and trumpet, in fact, was the top answer there with the instrument. Then I asked you to name... I think only the last answer was not the top answer. But I asked you to name an occasion when families get together. You said... weddings. If it's worth, what do we need? 36 or more, you've got it. You said weddings are... our survey said... 34. Yeah. Too short. Hang on. We need two. The top answer there was Christmas, and we'd had, right? I asked to name a country in South America. I nearly said South Africa. You said... Chile, if it's worth two or more, I can tell you that the top answer was Brazil and was worth 44, so you can't get that. But if Chile is worth two or more, you have the money. You said Chile, our survey said?
The family jump and dance in celebration.
Fancy another one? Oh, go on then. I don't mind if I do. Game on for more Family Fortunes next here on Challenge. And then later we dim the lights, turn up the tense music, and try and reach that £1 million mark. Classic Millionaire, weeknights at 10.
Congratulations, number three. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
These days, we all like things less complicated, more straightforward, especially if we're saying goodbye to a loved one. I talked to the people at Distinct Cremations, and they told me many of us don't want to spend large sums of money on an elaborate funeral. Their best value, five-star rated direct cremation plan guarantees a simple, low-cost funeral that leaves no hidden costs and no further bill to pay. It all makes sense to me. Something I'd want for myself, for sure, especially somewhere like here. If you're interested too, please contact Distinct Cremations and ask for this free guide. You'll be in very good company.
Call Distinct Cremations for a free guide on 0800 031 4393. That's 0800 031 4393. Or visit distinctcremations.co.uk.
Help your kids get to grips with their cash with NatWest Rooster Money. They can save for what they want, manage their money, and even help out to earn extra cash. You'll get alerts and can easily top them up. Download the app and sign up for your Rooster card. First month free, then $1.99 a month. Search NatWest Rooster Money in your app store. NatWest, tomorrow begins today.
definitely hoping to go below that red line. Pointless Celebrities, weeknights 7 on Challenge.
Give us a clickety-click if you can still hear us. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
An enthusiastic studio audience. Two sets of family teams facing each other. Behind one team, the word family. Behind the other, the word fortunes. The presenter's plinth and a central screen stand between the two families.
Fortunes, and tonight's families are Eddie, Lorraine, Sean, Sharon and Dave, the Edgell family from Chippenham in Wiltshire, and they're playing Josie, Wilma, Fiona, Margaret and Kate, the Gibson family from Dalrymple in Ayrshire, and here's your host, Les Dennis.
Les takes centre stage.
Thank you and welcome to the show. Once again, we have our answers in our computerised board. We ask our families to match those answers with a chance of winning £3,000. I've just been watching a video of the American Family of Fortunes made in the 1930s. And the host said, well, I'm afraid we have to lose the Bonnie and Clyde family now. But they take with them $3,000, as many prizes as they want, and the other family is hostages. Let's meet them. First of all, we meet the Edgell family. Is that right?
That's quite correct.
Eddie Edgell.
Pleased to meet you, Les.
How are you doing?
Very well, thank you.
Where have you brought your family from?
Well, two of us come from Chippenham. There's only one here. Two of us come from Corsham, but I'm the only one from Corsham at the moment, and the rest come from Chippenham.
Yeah, you forgot where you came from then, didn't you?
Right.
It's like that television, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Introduce us to your family.
This is my son-in-law, David.
Hi, Hi Dave.
My other son-in-law, Sean.
Hi, Hi, Sean.
And my twin girls, Lorraine and Sharon.
Hey, Lorraine and Sharon, hey, twins. Liz. And they both got bumps. Are you both having twins?
No.
No?
Thank goodness.
Lorraine, when's yours due?
Not till October.
Right, when's yours due, Sharon?
Next week.
It could be a long night, Sharon. You sure about this? I think we better get on and meet the other family. OK, let's go over and meet the Gibson family. Josie.
Hi, Liz.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Where have you brought your family from?
From a wee village in Ayrshire, Dalrymple, it's called. It's just about...
Dalrymple? Is that right? Is that the right set of accent there?
Dalrymple? You've got it just a bit
Dalrymple.
Right.
Dalrymple. I see you. Introduce us to your family, Josie.
This is my sister, Wilma.
Hello, Liz.
Hello, Wilma! I bet you get that all the time.
Another friend.
Another friend. No, I'm Barney. I'm with you, Fred.
My other sister, Fiona.
Hiya, Fiona.
Hi, Liz.
Another sister, Kate.
Hi, Kate.
Hi, Liz.
And another sister, Margaret.
Hiya, Margaret.
Hi, Liz.
All sisters.
Yep.
Great. And who's this?
This is Ben.
Ben? I thought you must be the Gibbon family when I saw that. Gibson family. He's your mascot, is he?
This is the mascot.
It's getting like blockbusters, this. Do you watch that?
Avid fan. I'm an avid fan.
Yeah. Can I have a pee, Bob? No, you should have gone before you came on. He does that, doesn't he? All right, that's the families. Let's play Family Fortunes. Eddie. I'm sure you know the rules by now, Josie and Eddie. 100 people have been surveyed, and we have, in this first game, the top 8 answers on the board. If you feel you have one of those answers, press your buzzer as hard as you can. We asked 100 people to name a quality a boss likes in his or her secretary. Eddie.
Punctuality.
Punctuality. Have you got a secretary?
No.
No? Punctuality. Yes, it's there. Answer number 3. So there are 2 more popular ones. Josie?
Efficiency.
Efficiency. OK, let's look for efficiency. Top answer. Well played. What do you want to do, Josie? Play or pass?
Please.
OK, rejoin your family and remember, no conferring. Gibbons? All right, Ben, how are you? We didn't say hello. Wilma, what do you think?
I think to be discreet.
To be discreet. Mm. OK. No. Good answer, but it wasn't there, Wilma. Fiona?
Unattached.
You're unattached, you're telling me.
No. He'd like his secretary to be.
Would he? Don't forget, it's his or her secretary, but we want unattached. All right. Single. Somebody to be single. Don't forget, we're looking for the best quality, not necessarily status. Kate.
Honesty.
No! Oh. So, three lies have gone. Sharon.
Smartness.
Smartness. I
totally agree. Smartness. Smartness.
You agree with that, Sean?
Smartness as well.
Yeah, you're going with that. Dave, a different answer?
I was going to say spelling, but you've got it out there.
Well, spelling. Spelling, all right, spelling.
Good spelling.
You haven't got spelling up there, have we?
Yeah. No.
Eddie, any answer of your own?
I'll take the smartness.
You're going to take smartness, OK? If smartness is one of those missing answers, you've stolen the money. We're looking for smartness. No. So, well played, the good teams. We're in the money. Let's have a look. Number 8 is... reliability. Number 7... accuracy. At doing what? Number 6, typing skills. Number 5, sex appeal. Who said that? Somebody said that. I think out there we got that from. And number 4 is good looks. Look at that. They're like good looks and sex appeal before typing skills. Eh? Is she a good typist? It doesn't matter, she's a stunner. All right, number 2 is neatness. Right, there are the answers. We've got £44. No money yet to the Edgels, but it's early days. Let's play on. Will Mandate. OK, we're looking in this second game for the top 6 answers. We asked 100 people to name something specific you may catch in a revolving door. Dave.
Umbrella.
Umbrella. All right.
I don't know what they're thinking.
I don't know what they're thinking. Well, I do, but I can't say. Umbrella! It's there! Well played. But there's a more popular one. Wilma.
Breast or chest?
Breast or chest? Oh, that'd be painful, wouldn't it? You've never done it, have you?
Nearly.
Yeah, yeah.
Nearly.
Then you went, yabba dabba doo! Breast or chest? No. So, Dave, you have control of the board. What do you want to do?
We play.
All right, then, rejoin your family. And remember, girls, you might get a chance to take the money later, so you should confer. I'll come to you, Sean. How are you?
Not so bad, thanks, Les.
Tell us a bit about yourself.
Well, I'm a plumber. I work for Eddie, self-employed.
Yeah? Do you?
Get on very well, yeah.
Any hobbies?
Yeah, I like shooting, clay pigeon shooting.
Any ambitions?
To be good at it.
Yeah. To be good at it?
Yeah.
All right, Sean, something specific you may catch in a revolving door.
Briefcase.
No, so we've lost a life. Lorraine.
Tie.
A tie. No, so we've lost 2. Sharon.
A coat.
A coat.
Yeah.
Coat or jacket. Well played, Sharon. You've saved that last life. So coat or jacket, 44 people said that, and you've won a prize.
Well, this is absolutely great for heating the baby's bottle. You've won a microwave.
Eddie.
Your foot.
Your foot. Foot! No! So, the Gibson family. Margaret, what do you think?
Somebody else's foot.
Somebody else's foot? If you don't like them. Kate?
Your hand.
Your hand. Fiona?
A shoe.
A shoe? Wilma?
A shoe or handbag.
A shoe or handbag. OK, we'll take handbag, because it's a different one. Josie, you can go with any of those answers, or you can choose your own.
Shoe.
Shoe. All right, you're going to go with shoe. If shoe is there, you've stolen the money. We're looking for shoe. No, so, well played. You've won the money, Eddie. £58, now plays £44. Right, answer number 6 is... a skirt or dress. Answer number 5 is... a handbag. Answer number 4 is... a scarf. And number 3... luggage or parcel. Briefcase was not the right kind of thing, not what we were looking for. We were looking more for suitcases or a parcel. But, you know, we actually surveyed Tom Jones in this, and he said he never goes near them. I wonder why. Let's play on. Fiona and Sean. OK, we're looking for the top 6 answers here. We asked 100 people to name something that doesn't work if it has a hole in it. Sean.
Pipe.
No. So, Fiona, what do you think?
A bucket or pail.
A bucket or pail. Yes, it's the top answer. Now that you've won, you have to sing it. There's a hole in my bucket. What do you want to do? Play. All right, rejoin your family. And remember, no conferring. But, of course, Ed Jules, you should come up with some answers. Kate?
Something that doesn't work if there's a hole in it.
Yeah.
A wash hand basin.
No! So, we've lost a life, Margaret.
A water hose.
No, so we've lost two lives. Got to go carefully now. So, I'd better just remind you of a question again, I think, Josie. Something that doesn't work if it has a hole in it.
A balloon.
Well done. You'll have to ask your mates. You've won a prize, Josie.
Well, Josie, no more washing down at the riverside. You've won yourself a washing machine with tumble dryer.
You just bought one.
I'll give it to my mum.
Give it to your mum. That's a good idea. Wilma, what do you think?
An umbrella.
Yes. Answer number two. Six people said umbrella. What do you do, Fiona? We haven't asked you. I haven't talked to you yet.
Nothing at the moment. I'm expecting a baby. Christmas Day.
Hey, really? Yeah. Hey, look. Catch you. Yeah?
No.
But what did you used to do for a living?
I used to be a labourer with the council.
You used to be a labourer?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yes.
What did you do? Kind of all the...
Dig ditches, put up fences, yeah. Things like that.
So it'll come in handy, actually, being a labourer. If,
yes.
if Sharon goes into labour, you can help us out.
Yeah, sure can.
All
I can swing
right,
a mail.
Something that doesn't work if it has a hole in it. Bit of thinking time there.
Wellingtons.
So, we come to you, Sharon.
A tyre.
A tyre?
Yes,
a tyre. Tyre?
Tyre.
Tyre?
Football.
Football. Eddie? Tyre or football or one of your own?
I've got to go for tyre.
You're going to go for tyre?
Tyre, I think.
It's got to have a hole in it to go around the wheel.
That's right.
Let's look and see if tyre's there. It is indeed. Well played. You've got the money. So, we've got £128. The Edgell family, the Gibson family have £44. Those missing answers. Number five, a boat. And number four is... A ball. You said that as well, didn't you? Yeah. Football. We're going to take a break. Join us in a couple of minutes when one of our families has the chance to play for £3,000. We'll see you then.
Congratulations, 82. You're straight on through to the next round.
You can't play here!
Come on.
We rise by lifting each other. Kenko, made to uplift.
Some people think life slows down in your 50s, but I'm just getting started and there's so much that I want to do. And yeah, I'll be retiring in a few years, so it makes sense to plan ahead. That's why I decided to learn more about over 50s life insurance from Cover Today. I know my lot don't need the money, but it's nice to leave a little something to help with funeral costs and other expenses, so they can spend their money on nicer things.
Cover Today are the only over 50s life insurer with no waiting period.
Unlike other insurers who can make you wait up to 2 years, with Cover Today, you're fully covered from day one. And you're covered for the whole of your life, so you can just get on with things. Plus, unlike other things in life, the price never goes up. Their claims process is really straightforward, so your loved ones will be looked after. Learning more couldn't be simpler and can be done in just a few minutes. Go online or talk to their friendly UK team who will chat you through your options in just one phone call. Cover Today are the only over 50s life insurer with no waiting period.
Get covered in minutes with no annoying trips to the doctor. With fixed monthly payments, prices start at just £4.42 a month.
Plus, you get your choice of a £125 gift card.
So stop putting it off and get it done. Then you can get on with doing something much more interesting.
To find out more about Cover Today, call our friendly UK team on 0800 9701 243 or visit covertoday.co.uk.
Making an ad is a bit of a faff, but skincare can be overwhelming. Sorting out your BHAs from your PHAs, your retinols from your retinals. At Trinity London, we want to demystify skincare, which is why we created our Match to Me technology. Simply tell us about you and your skin, and in just a few minutes, we will give you a routine that is entirely personalized to you. Welcome to the joy of sensational skin. Discover your routine at trinitylondon.com.
Holidays always cost more than you expect, don't they? The new pair of sunglasses at the airport, the cheeky lunchtime pina colada. With Lebara, one cost you don't have to worry about is EU roaming charges. Because, unlike most networks, with Lebara, there aren't any. They're all about saving you money. Just like this ad. No Hollywood actors here. That's why they hired me, Layla from Pearly. Lebara, smarter. Yes, could I get a pina colada?
How you feel when you're walking, playing, and lifting has a lot to do with how your body feels when you're sitting. That's why our exclusive chair fitting makes sure your neck, back, and hips are properly supported. Because when this feels good, so does everything else. And with up to 30% off in our summer sale, it's a perfect time to visit one of our showrooms or book a home visit. HSL. Feel good furniture.
It's taken me decades to know this body. Laughter lines, grey hairs. And whilst you might not remember me or the chicken pox rash I caused long ago, I'm still here, ready to reappear. This time, as shingles.
9 out of 10 adults in the UK have had chickenpox and therefore are at risk of shingles. So get to know shingles, as it's highly likely the virus that causes it knows you.
From the Arctic to the tropics and rivers to rainforests, get closer to islands bursting with life.
The galaxy still needs its guardians.
You're an idiot.
I am Groot.
Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. Available now in Sky Store.
Oh, Queen Bee, you've buzzed too early again.
Welcome back. At this stage in the game, the Edgels from Chippenham have won a microwave and £128. The Gibsons from Ayr, or Dalrymple near Ayr, have £44 and a washing machine with tumble dryer. There's quite a difference in the scores, but that could all change now as we play Double Money.
Les returns to the podium.
OK, Lorraine and Kate. If you need to sit down, just tell us, Lorraine.
Oh, I know.
OK, Double Money means just that. All the answers revealed. If they were worth a pound before, they're worth £2 and so on. Top six answers for you to find. Name an occupation that a small village might need only one of. Kate.
A blacksmith.
A blacksmith. Sounds good. What are you going like that for? Oh, sounds good to me. You nearly talked yourself out of that, then, didn't you? Lorraine.
A postman.
A postman. Top answer. Well played, Lorraine. Okay, rejoin your family. And remember, the Gibsons, you might get a chance to steal later, so you should get your heads together. Sharon, are you feeling okay?
Fine, thank you, Les.
An occupation that a small village might need only one of.
Milk round.
A milk round. Okay, a milk round. Milkman. Yep. Eddie.
A baker.
A baker. No. Good answer, but it's not there. Dave.
Hello.
You're an HGV driver.
That's right.
Do you ever have any trouble with it?
Sometimes, when they're a bit too high.
Yeah? Yep. What happened?
Well, I tried to get one under a bridge and it didn't quite go.
Yeah? What did you tell the policeman? You were delivering the bridge.
No, I was doing a wide load, yeah.
What do you think? An occupation that a small village might need only one of?
Village bobby.
A policeman, yes. It's there. You don't have to say evening, both. Sean.
Shopkeeper.
I think we have to be more specific. So, two lives have gone. The Gibsons get ready to maybe steal. Lorraine.
A doctor.
Yes, it's there.
We're going well.
So, there's only one answer to reveal, Sharon.
Dentist.
If a dentist is there, you have the money. We're looking for a dentist. No. So, what do you think, girls? Get in line so I can come to you. Margaret?
Street cleaner.
Street cleaner. Kate?
A district nurse.
A district nurse.
A minister.
A minister, Fiona. Wilma?
I would actually go with minister.
You go with minister. Mm-hmm. Josie, you can take any of those answers or go with one of your own. Gonna need one, though, Josie.
Minister.
You go with minister. All right, if minister is that missing answer, you have got the money. We're looking for minister. No, so... Well played, Eddie and family. You got the money. That missing answer, number four, is... a publican. Some of our studio audience said that, I think. OK, let's play on. Margaret and Sharon, still feeling OK?
Thank you, yeah.
Good. We asked 100 people, top five answers to find, to name something associated with Dracula. Margaret.
Blood.
Blood.
We're looking for the blood from Dracula. Blood.
It's a top answer. Play? OK, rejoin your family.
Hello, Josie. Something you would think about when you think of Dracula.
Bats.
Bats. OK, we're looking for the bats. Vampire bats. What do you think, Wilma?
A victim.
A victim?
A victim.
A victim, all right. One of his victims. No, so we lose a life. Fiona.
Fangs.
Fangs. You're welcome. Thanks for what? I haven't done anything.
Yet.
Fangs.
Fangs.
All right. Yes, it's there. Well done, Fiona. And you've won a prize. Steve.
Well, now, Fiona, you can have fun wherever you go. You've won a portable radio cassette compact disc player.
You can go on the beach and people will say, turn it down.
I'll take it off.
What do you think?
His long, flowing cloak.
His cloak.
Black cloak, yeah.
His cape. His cloak! No, good answer, but it wasn't there, so it means that we only have one life left and the Edgels might get a chance to steal. Got to go carefully now, because you need this to
stay in the game.
His
castle.
His castle. All right. We're looking for his castle. No. So, Sharon.
Coffin.
Coffin. Lorraine.
Either that or wooden stake.
Wooden stake. How do you like it? Medium or well done?
Coffin.
Coffin. Dave.
I'll say stake.
You go with stake. Eddie.
I'll go with a coffin.
You're going to go with a coffin?
Yes.
Well, if coffin is one of those missing answers, you go through the £300 barrier and play for big money. If not, the money goes to the Gibsons. We're looking for... coffin. Yes. Well played, Eddie. Well played. We're sorry to lose you, Josie.
It's OK.
Smashing family. You're taking £44 with you back to Dalrymple and a washing machine with tumble dryer and a radio cassette CD player. All right? But before you go, I'll reveal that missing answer for you. Got any ideas now?
Garlic.
Garlic. That's a good one. Let's have a look. Garlic. Never mind. They were smashing the Gibson. They played, Eddie. Who's going for the money?
My two daughters, Sharon and Lorraine.
Sharon and Lorraine, join me at the front mic. All right, Lorraine, you're playing first. Sharon, you're going to go and sit in the booth. If you don't come back, we know what's happened. All right, Lorraine. I'm going to ask you five questions. You have 15 seconds to answer. The time doesn't begin until I finish asking the first question. OK?
Yes.
Clear? Can I have 15 seconds on the clock, please? Name something a person uses as a disguise.
A moustache.
Something you put labels on.
Luggage.
A city featured in a song.
New York.
A sound you hear in the morning.
Alarm clock.
Something a cowboy might wear.
It's stirrups.
All right, good. Good answer. That's it. Fair enough. All right. Lorraine, you need 200 points to win that £3,000 to add to the £456 you have in the bank and the microwave oven. I first of all asked you to name something a person uses as a disguise. You said... a moustache. Our survey said... 14. Good start. On the board. Don't look so nervous. And then I asked you to name something you put labels on. You said luggage. Our survey said 28. Going well. I then asked you to name a city featured in a song. You said New York. New York. Our survey said start spreading the news. We're on the board. 78. I then asked you to name a sound you hear in the morning. You said the alarm clock. Our survey said 33. 111. Finally, I asked you to name something a cowboy might wear. You said stirrups. Our survey said nothing for stirrups. Good answer, but it wasn't there. But we've got 111 points. It's a good score. Rejoin your family and we'll clear the board. We'll bring Sharon back. Welcome back, Sharon. The little one. OK. I can tell you that Lorraine got 111 points, so that means you have to get 89 points. I'm going to ask you the same five questions. You have 20 seconds to answer. If you duplicate any of the answers, we'll hear this sound. I'll ask you for another answer. Can we remind the viewers at home of the answers that Lorraine gave me? And can I have 20 seconds on the clock, please? Good luck. Name something a person uses as a disguise.
Moustache.
Another.
Glasses.
Something you put labels on.
Parcel.
A city featured in a song.
Dublin.
A sound you hear in the morning.
Alarm clock.
Another.
Radio.
Something a cowboy might wear.
Hat.
Yes. OK. Well done. All right. We need 89 points to win that 3,000. First of all, I asked you to name something a person uses as a disguise. You said glasses. Our survey said 16. Good, 127. So what do we need now? 73. The top answer there was wig. It was worth 27. Then I asked you to name something you put labels on. You said a parcel. Our survey said 12. Steady scoring. 139. We now need 61. The top answer there was jars and was worth 30. So I then asked you to name a city featured in a song. We'd already had the top answer, which was New York. But you said Dublin. Our survey said nothing for Dublin. Then I asked you to name a sound you hear in the morning. First of all, you said alarm, which we already had. Then you said radio. Our survey said nothing for radio. Hard luck. The top answer was birds and was worth 35 and would have put you on the way. So we still need, what, 61 from this last answer to win the money. Don't worry, we could do it, you never know. I then asked you to name something a cowboy might wear. You said hat. Our survey said 47. Top answer. This wasn't enough. Hard luck. Look, 186, we'll double that. We'll add it to the money you have in the bank, which gives you an Edgell family fortune of £828 plus the microwave. Well done. Rejoin your family. Hard luck. Hard luck, Eddie. Okay. We'll see you next week on Family Fortunes. Bye.
The lifelines are in play next as Chris Tarrant asks the question, who wants to be a millionaire? Wouldn't we all? That's on the way here on Challenge. And later, Michael Barrymore welcomes three more couples hoping to avoid those hotspots. It's Strike It Lucky, weekdays at 3.
You've made us wait long enough. What's your final answer? Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
Testing 1, 2. We're ready.
Biggest bounce of the summer. Hey, my girl, what you say? It's the biggest bounce of the summer.
It's a huge hit.
Hey, what you say?
Outstanding.
From the track like a runner.
What a shot that is.
Hey, hey, hey. If
you come in and come down, play, play.
It's a one-hander.
Watch, watch by me.
Oh!
Catch the return of the 100 live on Sky Sports.
Definitely hoping to go below that red line. Pointless Celebrities, weeknights 7 on Challenge.
Congratulations, number 3. You said cup of tea. That's the top answer. Mecca Bingo Online, sponsors of Challenge.
A group of people are standing and staring at beams of multicolored light radiating from a glowing disc, the edge of which is encircled by the name of the program. Classic Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Year 3, Episode 25, presented by Chris Tarrant.
When our Bernard and Bronn, they're still not sure about all this. They've been together 26 years. They have 3 kids. They have 2 grandkids. Evan, who's 7, and Mitchell, as you can see in this photo, he's the one on the left. He's 9 years old today, actually, which is rather sweet, and would love to have Grandpa wish him a happy birthday. Come on, Bern. Come on.
Happy birthday, Mitchell. I won't do it in Dutch. He's Dutch, and I...
Hey?
My Dutch is not good. He's Dutch.
Well, he'll understand happy birthday.
He understands happy birthday. I'd like to do it in Dutch.
Don't risk it. OK. Happy birthday from all of us. Bernard wants to win enough money tonight to give up work, as he thinks retirement would be wonderful. And he and Bronn could spend their time cruising the Azores. Though he does so as a student, Bernard once had what sounds like a dream job. He was a water tester in a distillery. And as a result, says he wasn't sober for a full 3 months. Is that right?
That's absolutely right.
That's a great story. How did you get that job?
I worked for the company who owned it anyway, and they like to keep me gainfully employed in the holidays.
Yeah.
And that was what I got off to do.
God. You seem a very amiable, plastic kind of a guy, Bern, but you get very, very worked up watching this programme.
Yes, I did.
Until you saw...
Until I saw the reality. And they're not stupid. They're just terrified like
me. Yeah, yeah, basically, yeah. It's everybody says the same old thing. They say, oh, I do really well at home, but it's, yeah. You know now, it's very different, isn't it?
Yeah, very different.
Well, you've got £1,000, you've got all your lifelines intact. Next question is worth £2,000. Question number 6. Have a look, tell us what you want to do. Who played Terry McCann in the TV series Minder? Dennis Waterman. Patrick Mower. Barry Foster. Patrick Allen.
Dennis Waterman.
Sure, sure?
Yeah.
Final answer.
That's
the right answer. You've got £2,000.
Bernard's wife smiles and applauds in the audience.
Right. You got £2,000. You got all 3 lifelines still intact, which is good. You are 9 right answers away from 1 million. This is question number 7. Which playing cards do the Americans call deuces? Aces. Twos. Sevens. Tens.
Twos.
Twos?
Twos.
Deuces, or some of them call them deuces. Final answer.
Final answer.
So right answer, you've now got £4,000.
Bernard's wife is again shown applauding.
You got £4,000. This would double your money to £8,000. You've still got all 3 lifelines intact. Have a look. This is question number 8 of a possible 15. Who topped the UK charts in 1972 with Schools Out? Rod Stewart. Alice Cooper. Mark Bolan. Chuck Berry.
Alice Cooper.
You're looking very puzzled when that came up. Now you're very confident.
I was singing it. Well, making a noise.
What, in your head?
Yes.
Were you? How did it go then?
School's out forever. Now you know why, though. I never took up singing as a kid.
No, funny that.
No, it's amazing.
Yes.
Or dancing. Same reason.
Well, no, you know, no. Right. Final answer.
Final answer.
It's the right answer. You got £8,000.
He purses his lips as he sighs with relief.
You got £8,000. Next question is for £16,000, Bernard. It's going rather well, actually, isn't it? You shouldn't say this yet.
No, I won't say that.
You got all three lifelines. Okay. Question number 9 is for £16,000. Have a look, take your time. You can obviously play 1, 2, or 3 lifelines and still take that money. Here it comes. At which Winter Olympics did Torville and Dean win gold? Lake Placid, Sarajevo, Lillehammer, Albertville.
Sarajevo.
Final answer.
Final answer.
It's the right answer. You got 16,000.
Bernard's wife looks a little surprised as she applauds. End of part one.
Who's behind the door? It's number 4.
Our hair colour is us. So when we change it, it goes deep. It brightens our mood. Puts us in control. And that's powerful. So go pink. Embrace tangerine. Try blonde or switch it up. Embrace the power of colour with Schwarz Spot Live. Own it with our caring colour routine. Lighten the live way. Tone and banish brassiness. Colour vibrantly and boost it. Powerful colour that cares with Schwarz Spot Live.
I like to think ahead. Make sure I've got all the right tools for the job.
And now that I've turned 50, it means looking after what I've built. I'll be retiring down the line, and with the mortgage nearly done, I want to make sure that my lot will be protected if anything happened to me. That's why I decided to learn more about over 50s life insurance from Cover Today. They're the only over 50s life insurer with no waiting period. Unlike other insurers who could make you wait up to 2 years for full cover, with Cover Today, you're fully covered from day one. And you're covered for the whole of your life. Plus, unlike other things in life, the price never goes up. Learning more couldn't be simpler and can be done in just a few minutes. Go online or talk to one of their friendly UK team who will chat you through your options in just one phone call. And their claims process is really straightforward, so your loved ones will be looked after.
Cover Today are the only over 50s life insurer with no waiting period. Get covered in minutes with no annoying trips to the doctor. With fixed monthly payments, prices start at just £4.42 a month. Plus, you get your choice of a £125 gift card.
Cover Today has given me genuine peace of mind. And now that's done, I can get on with something much more interesting.
To find out more about Cover Today, call our friendly UK team on 0800 458 6915 or visit covertoday.co.uk.
It's competition time. How would you like to win £7,000 cash? This is our brand new competition with a huge jackpot of £7,000 in tax-free cash. For your chance to win £7,000, you must find the TV programme we've hidden in this letter grid. Here's a little hint. The hidden TV programme is about a doctor that flies through space and time in a TARDIS. Calls will only last 1 minute. To win £7,000, you will have 60 seconds from now to try and find the hidden TV programme. Once you've spotted it, call the competition entry line on screen for your chance to win £7,000. Keep looking for the hidden TV programme. Remember, calls will last only 1 minute for your chance to win £7,000. You could also win an additional £3,000 by finding the name of a planet we have also hidden in the letter grid. Find both words and £10,000 could be yours. Over 18s only. Full T&Cs at www.winfall.co.uk. Keep looking, as we're nearly out of time. Try and find the hidden TV programme in the grid for the chance to win £7,000 cash. Remember, there's also the name of a planet hidden in the grid. If you can find the hidden planet, you can win an additional prize of £3,000 cash. Enter by calling the competition entry line on screen. I hope you found the TV programme hidden in the grid. Good luck!
Traditional heritage craft. Crafts that are in danger.
Whoa. Oh.
Join us as we meet the generation keeping three of these traditional skills alive.
Now that's what I call lucky.
Part two.
Right, you've got £16,000. Question number 10. This will be good. Question number 10 would guarantee you £32,000. Small buds on the tongue can distinguish four basic tastes: sweet, sour, bitter, and which other? Syrup, spice, smoke, salt.
Salt.
Bernard's wife also presses D on her keypad.
Why are you so confident?
I was looking for it before it came up.
Do you want to play it?
I do.
They lose £15,000 if you're wrong.
No, salt, final answer.
I can tell you that Bron also thinks the answer is salt. That's the right answer. You got £32,000.
Bernard shakes Chris's hand.
Feel better? Feel much better.
Feel better now.
Have a look. Whatever happens, you go away tonight with at least that amount of money. Don't we don't want to give you that? You got 32,000. We close to retirement yet?
Not yet.
Ooh, how much more do we have to get?
Ooh, I'd think seriously at 125. And if ever got anywhere near 250, don't even think about it.
You're only five away from a million, and you have three lifelines. Question number 11. Now, you might as well play it. You can't lose on this. You've got three lifelines anyway. This is for £64,000. You're guaranteed £32,000. Which of these is a novel by Anne Bronte? Agnes White. Agnes Black. Agnes Grey. Agnes Green. Now, you've got £32,000, that's safe.
Right.
You've got three lifelines.
Right, I think I'd like to phone a friend on this one.
OK, so who are you going to phone?
Maeve.
Maeve?
Yes.
Who's Maeve?
She's a friend, old friend of mine, or ours. From
Bron know about Maeve?
Oh, yes.
Oh, well. Yes.
Very well.
Testing? OK. Do you want me to tell Maeve how much money is involved?
Yes. Yes.
Won't phase her?
No, she's a sensible lady.
We'll see.
Hello?
Maeve?
Yes?
Hi, it's Chris Tarrant here. Good evening.
Oh, hello.
Oh, hello. Maeve, as you probably gathered, I've got Bernard here. Bernard and Bron are here.
Yes?
He's doing rather well.
Oh, good.
In fact, very good. He's on £32,000.
Oh, how lovely.
But, Maeve, better news.
Yes?
Well, it does mean that with your answer, we could get him up to £64,000.
Yes.
Ah. OK, well, now, the next voice here will be Bernard's.
Yes.
I tell you a question, there are still four possible answers. One of them is worth £64,000.
Right.
All right, mate, fingers crossed, darling. Bernard,
yes.
30 seconds.
Thank you.
Your time starts now.
Which of these is a novel by Anne Bronte? Agnes White, Agnes Black, Agnes Grey, or Agnes Green?
I think Agnes Grey, but I can't be certain.
OK, Maeve, thank you very much.
That's all I can say.
OK, fine. See you soon.
OK. Bye.
Now, what are you going to do? You've got two other lifelines if you need them.
No, I'll go with Agnes Grey. I did think it was Agnes Grey, so I'll take the chance on Agnes Grey.
You hadn't a clue. You said.
Well, you're probably right. No, I think I had a clue, but I will go with Agnes Grey. I'll go with Maeve on that one.
Final answer.
Final answer.
Chris looks at Bernard, giving nothing away.
Anything you've done?
I don't know.
You've done well. You just won £64,000.
He gets another handshake from Chris.
Right, let's have a look. This is question number 12 of a possible 15. It's for £125,000. An eagle, a cactus and a snake are depicted on the national flag of which country? Bolivia, Ecuador, Mexico, Uganda.